Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today being the first Friday of the month, let us offer this Eucharist in honor of the most sacred heart of Jesus. Let us pray that our hearts may be like the heart of Jesus, a heart full of love, a heart full of compassion, a heart full of mercy. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic prayer, Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge that we are sinners and that we have a Lord who we can turn to and ask for forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conform to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, thus should one regard us, as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Now, it is of course required of stewards that they be found trustworthy. It does not concern me in the least that I be judged by you or any human tribunal. I do not even pass judgment on myself. I am not conscious of anything against me, but I do not thereby stand acquitted. The one who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, do not make any judgment before the appointed time, until the Lord comes, for he will bring to light what is hidden in darkness and will manifest to the motives of our hearts, and then everyone will receive praise from God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The salvation of the judge, of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Trust in the Lord and do good, that you may dwell in the land and be fed in security. Take delight in the Lord, and he will grant you your heart's request.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Commit to the Lord your way, trust in him, and he will act. He will make justice dawn for you like the light. Bright as the noonday shall be your vindication.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Turn from evil and do good, that you may abide forever. For the Lord loves what is right and forsakes not his faithful ones. Criminals are destroyed, and the posterity of the wicked is cut off.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just is from the Lord. He is their refuge in time of distress, and the Lord helps them and delivers them. He delivers them from the wicked and saves them, because they take refuge in him.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The scribes and Pharisees said to Jesus, "The disciples of John the Baptist fast often and offer prayers, and the disciples of the Pharisees do the same, but yours eat and drink." Jesus answered them, "Can you make the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? But the days will come, and when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and they will fast in those days." And he also told them a parable. "No one tears a piece from a new clock to patch an old one. Otherwise, he will tear the new, and the piece from it will not match the old clock. Likewise, no one pours new wine into old wineskins. Otherwise, the new wine will burst the skins, and it will be spilled, and the skins will be ruined. Rather, new wine must be poured into fresh wineskins, and no one who has been drinking old wine desires new, for he says, 'The old is good.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
"But the days will come, and when the bridegroom is taken away from them, then they will fast in those days." I think the point of Jesus in this phrase in the gospel is timing. There is proper time. Now is not the time, but time will come that fasting is appropriate. May tamang panahon. Darating at mangyayari ang lahat sa tamang panahon. Hindi sila nag-aayuno ngayon sapagkat kapiling nila ang lalaking ikakasal. Pero may tamang panahon pag wala na ang lalaking ikakasal. I think, my dear brothers and sisters, this is a very important thing to remember, that time, God's time, is not the same as our own time. Sometimes when we pray, we want immediate answer. And when we do not get what we pray for, we will think that the Lord is not listening to us, that the Lord is ignoring our prayer, that the Lord does not love us. Hindi po. Mahal tayo ng Diyos at ibibigay niya ang tama para sa atin sa tamang oras. Kaya kung hindi pa dumarating, hindi pa panahon. Doon din tinuturuan tayo na magtiwala sa pamamaraan ng Diyos. Kasi kumisan, gusto nating tayo ang maging Diyos. Nais nating pasunurin ang Diyos sa gusto natin. Hindi po. There is time for everything. If our prayers are not being answered, it is not yet time. Balikan ninyo yung mga karanasan ninyo sa buhay. Hindi ba? May mga pagkakataon na naranasan na rin ninyong dumating ang isang hinihintay niyo at nasabi niyo na lang sa inyong sarili, kaya pala, ito pala ang tamang panahon. So that's the first point that I would like to ask to reflect on, timing. And since the Lord is also speaking to the scribes and Pharisees, the latter part of the gospel pertains to them. The scribes and Pharisees have not been able to adjust themselves to the time, to the changes. Sabi ng Panginoon, no one pours new wine into old wineskins. Alam nyo, nung araw, wala namang boteng babasagin. Nakalagay ang mga alak sa mga wineskins na yari sa balat ng tupa o balat ng kambing. Yun ang kanilang lalagyan ng alak. At ang sabi ng Panginoon, simple, practical, bagong alak dapat ilagay sa bagong sisidlan. Sapagkat kapag ang bagong alak ay inilagay sa lumang lalagyan, sisirain ng bagong alak ang lumang sisidlan. At masasayang pareho ang alak at ang sisidlan. What is the point of Jesus in these words? The point is this. Times have changed. Jesus came bringing new teachings. And the scribes and Pharisees must learn how to adjust. Eh, yun ang kanilang problema. At problema din ng ilan sa atin. Sasabihin natin, hindi na ako magbabago. Ito na ang nakasanayan ko eh. Dito na ako nasanay. Dito na ako tumanda. Pero huwag niyong kalilimutan, hindi lahat ng nakasanayan ay dapat ipagpatuloy. Hindi lahat ng pinagkatandaan ay dapat na ituloy. Ang gusto ng Panginoon, ang kanyang bagong aral dapat ay makapag-adjust ang tao at pakinggan at tanggapin. Times have changed. Hindi natin pwedeng sabihin, ganito na akong noon eh. Ganito na ako hanggang wakas. And it is also an invitation to us. ano yung mga bagay na nakasanayan natin na dapat nating baguhin? Ano yung mga bagay na naging ugali na natin pero dapat nating palitan? Doon natin makikita ang tunay na pagbabago. So, there is time for everything. And when the times have changed, we have to learn how to adapt, how to adjust. Let us pray for the grace of adaptability, the grace of conversion, the grace of change, that when the Lord is leading us to something new, we will be able to respond to it positively. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray to God our Father that He bring us closer to the values of the gospel to renew the church and the world. To every petition, our response would be, renew us, O Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That the church, the people of God, and its leaders may follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit to speak to the people of today the ever new language of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That we may open our hearts to God's saving power in Christ, which is much more important than observing an ancient religious practice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That we may realize that the miracle of change is always possible for those who seek Christ's help in attaining it. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That we may become channels of the Lord's caring hands to the sick by showing them love and concern. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That the dead may find eternal rest in the company of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayer. And teach us the art of living as a new people set free by the love of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, Father of mercies, who because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, Grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I would like us to thank Father Rolly Villanueva from San Jose, Mindoro, for joining us in this noontime Eucharist. Actually, he has a wedding after this at 1:30, but he decided to join us also. So thank you, Father Rolly, and welcome. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Ipinagmanawili ka.